faster than a speeding bullet, more powerful than a locomotive, able to leap tall buildings at a single bound. Look, up in the sky, it's a bird, it's a plane, it's Superman!
Kellogg's Pep! P-E-P, Pep! Kellogg's Pep, the Sunshine Cereal, presents...
The Adventures of Superman! Today, the Daily Planet's attack on the Clan of the Fiery Cross has brought their vengeance down on Perry White, and the symbol of hatred burns again, this time at the door of the gray-haired editor.
Hello there, gang. This is your pal, Dan McCullough. Say, you like to travel, don't you? Well, how about letting your imagination travel to Egypt tomorrow morning and have yourself a Pep pyramid for breakfast? You know, that's this week's Pep Dish of the Week, named for the pyramids of Egypt and planned to give your appetite a real buildup. Here's how it goes. In the bottom of your bowl, pile up your serving of Kellogg's Pep, the Sunshine cereal, in the shape of a pyramid. Then at the foot of your Pep pyramid, scatter some fruit, you know, like juicy red raspberries. Add milk and sugar, and there's your Pep pyramid, the newest way to show you what Kellogg's Pep can do for fresh, ripe fruit. Mm-mm. How Pep Sunshine flavor does rise and shine. How that sunny, golden, toasted goodness does tickle your taste. Why, Kellogg's Pep is so good, you'll be busy eating until you've finished off every last bit in your bowl. Which is the smart thing to do, especially nowadays, when we're sending the cereal grains to fellows and girls overseas. Remember that when Mom brings Kellogg's Pep home from the grocer's. Don't waste it. If you pour your own Pep, pour it carefully and eat up every bit you pour out. That's important, gang. Eat all your Pep. Don't waste it.
And now, the adventures of Superman. On the Clan of the Fiery Cross, a group of intolerant fanatics attacked a Chinese boy named Tommy Lee, star pitcher on Jimmy Olsen's Unity House baseball team. Only the prompt action of Superman saved the innocent boy's life. Furious, editor Perry White published a scathing editorial against the Klan in the Daily Planet and offered a $1,000 reward to anyone who could identify a single one of the robed and hooded bigots. That night, when White, Jimmy, and Clark Kent drove up to the editor's suburban home, they were startled to see a huge cross of fire burning on White's front lawn. Listen.
Great Scott! Look, Chief!
Oh. Gee whiz.
A burning cross.
That's the symbol of the Klan. It means those hate mongers have selected you as their next victim, Chief.
Sleeping lizards, no, they can't.
Quick, we've got to call the fire department.
Well, don't bother, someone's already done that. Come on, Chief, pull out of their way.
Well, good night. Good night, Mr. Pittman, and thanks for your offer, but we'll be all right.
Boy, I thought your neighbors would never leave, Chief.
Yeah, so did I. Well, hasn't this been an exciting half hour?
Yes, and frightening, too.
Frightening? Huh. If this was meant to frighten me, it was a total waste of time.
Holy smokes, Chief. Don't you know what a burning cross means?
Why, sure I know. It's a warning for me to lay off the Klan. But I'll be hanged if I'll knuckle under to a bunch of ignorant cowards who hide behind hoods and sheets.
These men are dangerous. Granted, they're cowardly. They're still dangerous while they remain anonymous.
And how? But look, what I can't figure out, Mr. Kent, is why they're picking on Mr. White. He's no foreigner, and his skin's not...
The reason's obvious, Jim.
You mean it's because of my editorial telling of the rotten history of the Klan and pointing out the un-American bigotry they stand for?
Exactly.
Well, they won't make me shut up. I'll keep after them until they're brought out into the open and...
Sure, sure, I know you will, Chief, but you must take precautions. I can't watch over you every minute.
You?
I mean, we. That is, I'm sure Inspector Henderson will assign a couple of plainclothes men, but even
not
they...
Not to me, he won't. I'm not going to let those scoundrels think I'm scared of them.
Oh, but look, Chief.
I think Mr. Kent is right.
I don't care what you think, or Kent either. The Klan is going to find out that I mean business, and that they can't scare me with their mumbo-jumbo and burning crosses.
But you
can't... Now, no more arguments. First, we'll have something to eat, and then we'll go to work. Poco!
See, that's strange. Poco isn't here, Chief.
Well, of course he's here. Poco!
Oh, I tell you he isn't here.
Then I tell you he is. I talked to him just before we left the office. Told him to have some supper ready for us.
But...
Poco! Where are you, you lazy beggar? He's not in the kitchen. Pogo!
Well, maybe he's in his room, Mr. White.
No, he isn't there either.
Oh, how do you know he isn't, Mr. Kent? Can't see from here.
Oh, no. Well, I've just got a feeling he isn't.
Funny, he's not in his room either. And he didn't finish preparing supper. The stuff spread all around the kitchen and the refrigerator is open.
Hey, I don't like this.
Hey, maybe he got scared by the burning cross and went upstairs.
No, I tell you, he isn't...
Sure, that's probably what happened. He's probably under my bed scared to death. Come on, we'll go up and get him.
No, don't bother. He isn't upstairs, Chief.
Kent, are you trying to tell me that you can look through the ceiling like Superman?
Oh, no, but I tell you, he... Great Scott!
Huh?
Well, what's the matter?
The garage! Come on, follow me! See? There's Poco, Chief.
Where?
Over there, lying in the corner of the garage.
Jeepers. What's the matter with him? Poco.
I can't hear you, Jim. He's unconscious.
Unconscious?
Yes.
Poor little fella.
What happened to him?
Wait, let's have a look. I'll turn him over.
Is he alive?
Yes, but...
Gosh, look at his face. All cut up and...
Good heavens. The poor chap must have been in an accident.
I don't think it was an accident, Chief. I think Poco was beaten up.
Beaten?
Oh, who'd want to beat up poor little Poco, Mr. Candy? Why, he never heard a fly.
Tommy Lee and his father never heard anyone either, Jim.
Tommy Lee and his father? You mean...
The Fiery Cross Gang?
Yes. Unless I miss my guess, our friends in the hoods and sheets did this dirty piece of work.
The rats. The dirty rats.
Jim, you run ahead and get the first aid kit out, will you? I'll carry Poco into the house. Hurry. Take it easy now. Drink a little more water, Poco. Easy. There. How do you feel now?
Oh, woe is me. Such misery.
Do you hurt very much, Poco?
My body, Jim, is a mass of pain. I'm sure I'll never walk again.
Oh, you'll walk all right.
Why, yes, of course you will. Who did this to you, Poco?
Some terrible men who sneaked out of the night. Oh, dear. They gave me such a fright. Each wore a sheet and a hood over his head, like ghosts who came back from the dead.
They weren't ghosts, Poco. They were the clan of the Fiery Cross.
The scoundrels. Now, what happened, Poco? Why did they beat you up?
They were burning a cross upon our lawn. I was frightened, but I told them to be gone. They struck me down and kicked me, too. That's all I recall till I saw you. Except they said...
Why, the dirty...
Just a moment, Jim. What did they say, Poco?
I'm so hurt and so sore, I can hardly talk anymore.
Well, just try to tell us what they said, Poco.
They said... Tell White. We'll get him, too. Unless he lays off us in his newspaper.
Said they'd get me, eh? Well, we'll see who gets home. If they think they can shut me up by burning a cross on my lawn, by beating up poor Poco, well, just wait till they see the Daily Planet tomorrow.
Oh, you will. From in there.
What are you jumpy about, Frank? The latest story in the Daily Planet raising the reward for us to $5,000?
Yeah, that's a lot of dough, Will. Somebody might get tempted to take a chance and spill on us. And
well, that's why I'm here. Matt Riggs says for you to be ready for action at 6 o'clock tonight. You got that?
Yeah. What's going to happen?
You'll find out tonight. Be ready for action at 6.
Glad you dropped in, Will. I want to ask you about the new story in the Planet about us. How did the White raise the reward of $5,000?
I know all about it, George. That's why I'm here. Matt Riggs says for you to be ready for action at 6 o'clock tonight.
At 6, huh? What are we going to do?
You'll find out tonight. Just be ready for action at 6 o'clock.
Say, I'm glad you showed up, Will. Look, you tell Matt we got to do something about that lousy Daily Planet.
He's a way ahead of you, Hank. We're going to take care of that tonight.
Yeah, that's what Matt said last night, but the burning cross didn't shut White's big mouth. He's raising such a fuss, every cop in the metropolis is looking for
him. We know, but don't worry. He won't raise any more fuss after tonight, Hank. I'll guarantee you that. You just be ready for action at 6 o'clock. This is going to be the works.
Going from one Klansman to another, Will Jennings, the mouthpiece for Matt Riggs, Grand Scorpion of the Clan of the Fiery Cross, gives the order to stand by for action tonight. What will happen? We'll know in just a moment. So stand by for the tense climax of today's episode.
You know, gang, if every home in the country could be wired for sound, you'd hear a big chorus of compliments come breakfast time from thousands and thousands of homes where Kellogg's Pep heads the menu. Sure, things like, "Gee, Mom, this is a nifty treat," or, "Boy, is this super," because Kellogg's Pep is that kind of a dish. You know, Pep is called the Sunshine Cereal. It's loaded to the brim with sunshine flavor, a golden toasted flavor that gets your appetite wide awake in a jiffy. And Pep is crunchy, too, tender and crisp as can be. Not to mention the fact that Kellogg's Pep is good for you. Sure, gives you solid whole wheat nourishment plus. Yes, sir, that's how Pep stacks up. It's so delicious, you keep right on eating until you've polished off your bowl clean as a whistle. And you know, gang, it's extra important nowadays not to waste cereal, because the cereal grains have been picked out to help give good nourishment to fellows and girls all over the world. So when Mother brings Kellogg's Pep home from the grocer's, make sure there's no waste at your house. Pass the word along to the rest of your family, too. It's the right idea to eat all your Pep. Don't waste it.
At 6:15 that same evening, Daily Planet editor Perry White impatiently drums his fingers on the desk in his office, then rises to his feet.
Well, come on, Olson, we're going home.
Going home? But you promised to wait for Mr. Kent.
I know, but he said he'd be here at 6, and it's 6:15 now. Our editorial said for anyone wanting to give information about the Klan after 6 o'clock to call me at home, so we'd better get going. I don't want to risk missing a call.
Oh, but Mr. Kent said for you not to leave the office without him.
Mr. Kent said? Is he running this newspaper, or am I?
You are, I guess, but I...
You guess?
Well, sure, of course you are. But Mr. Kent said you were in danger,
Baloney.
And not to leave until he got here. He said he might be a little later than 6, but he said...
If you don't stop that he said stuff, I...
Oh, now, look,
you quiet. What do you and Kent think I am, a babe in arms?
No, but...
But nothing. The Klan wouldn't dare lay a finger on me. They were just trying to scare me into turning off the heat on them.
I don't know about that. I think...
Well, I do know. Well, get your hat and come along.
Kent's going to be awful sore when he gets to the planet and finds you gone, Mr. White.
Yeah, I'm shuddering in my boots. Do you think he'll fire me?
I don't think it's any joking matter. Those fiery cross clan guys are bad actors. They...
What's that fool blowing his horn for?
I don't know. Maybe you better pull over, Mr. White. Looks like he wants to pass us.
Well, let him. I'm doing 35. That's the legal speed limit on this highway. I'm on my side of the road.
Here he comes.
Hey, get over there. What are you trying to do?
It's a truck.
I don't care what it is. He's crowding us off the road. Hey, watch out!
Look out, hey! Mr. White, you're going off the road. Oh, that was too close.
That stupid truck driver deliberately crowded us off the road, almost sent us into the ditch. Believe me, I'll tell him a thing or two.
Hey, White Chief, look.
I'm waiting for nothing. I'm going to...
Holy smokes. Look, those men jumping out of the truck. They're wearing sheets and hoods.
Good Godfrey. They're the Klan of the Fiery Cross.
Blood suddenly running cold, Jimmy Olsen and Perry White sit rigidly in their car as some 20 robed and hooded men leap from the truck and run threateningly toward them. What will happen to gray-haired editor White and his young reporter, with Superman unaware that they are now trapped by the hate-mongering bigots of the Klan of the Fiery Cross? There's much excitement ahead, so don't miss tomorrow's thrilling episode, gang. Tune in, same time, same station.
And remember, for breakfast, it's Kellogg's Pep.
For excitement, the adventures of Superman.
Superman is a copyrighted feature appearing in Superman DC comic magazines and is brought to you Monday through Friday at the same time by Kellogg's Pep, the Sunshine Cereal.
Say, if you want your dog to tag right along with the gang, if you want him to be strong and husky, don't let him eat just to fill up. Mix his scraps of meat and fat in with Kellogg's Grow Pup dog food. Then just see if you don't get congratulations on what a fine dog you have. Grow Pup has what it takes to help keep a dog hitting on all fours, and it's full of swell, meaty flavor dogs like. Besides, there are three different kinds of Grow Pup. Grow Pup Ribbon, Grow Pup Meal, and Grow Pup Pellets. Ask Mother to start feeding your dog Kellogg's Grow Pup today. And be sure to be with us tomorrow for the thrilling adventures of Superman. This is the Mutual Broadcasting System.